oh my gosh, I can't believe, I know it's numb, but it's like gone.
Rebecca, who some of you remember from an earwax cleaning video, has been having headaches and does have migraine. And this particular headache you've been having now for the last 3 weeks.
Just about then, yeah.
Mostly on, a little off, maybe a couple hours of a break daily, but not even every day.
Right.
And we're going to use a technique of nerve block on the greater and lesser occipital nerves where they come out in the back of the skull.
So you're going to do 2 and 2, right?
2 and 2. Okay. The purpose is to block those nerves that serve sensation not only for the outside of the skull, but even on the inside where you're actually feeling the pain of the headache.
Okay.
This will most often totally break a migraine. So I was taught this technique at USC by Dr. Soma Sahi-Scrivastava. Forgive me, Soma, if I got your name wrong, but
no.
Thank you so much for teaching. And so many of my followers on YouTube, they know when I was there because I made a little, or tried to make a little video on their internet connection while I was down there. But we're going to bring that teaching from USC at their neurology conference to you right now.
Okay.
And we're going to show how we do it. I do it a little differently from Soma. The way I'm doing it differently is that I'm using epinephrine with the lidocaine, which I know that from my procedural background.
It numbs it a little bit?
It helps to numb it longer. The epinephrine will limit blood flow to and from the area.
Okay.
So it doesn't get filtered out and cleaned out. It also makes for less bleeding, which everybody likes.
Yes.
Now, when we do these shots in people's, it's right where your hair is. So we're not really doing a clean injection, but we're being very careful.
Okay.
We go ahead and we do a couple things to make it easier. We rub the skin with an alcohol wipe so there's a little less bacteria on it. We don't shave hair off, and we don't need to because nobody really gets infections from this. And then she also sprays with a topical anesthetic spray that I'll put on it that makes it a little bit easier when you get the shot, but we're just using really tiny needles. Yeah, you remember that one. So we'll get started right away.
Okay.
So I'm gonna push your hair forward.
Do what you need to.
Okay. There we go. Come along. So hair forward. And people may notice you have a little coloration on your neck, and that's nothing abnormal. That's
no, you wore my hair down, so it's fine.
Yeah, people have coloration there. That's not part of what's going on here. So I'm going to be pushing, and possibly a little uncomfortably pushing. First, I'm finding the prominence of the occiput. The occipital prominence is kind of in the middle.
Yeah, that's where it looks.
Yeah.
There, and then for the down, yeah. There too, yeah.
And
those are two places you're going to be using.
Well, I'm going to be going between that and the upper part of the tragus is right. Let me look here, right here. So if you draw a line between those, I'm going to be going at the midpoint for the greater occipital nerve, and then halfway between what's left for the lesser occipital nerve. So that means I'm going to be pushing right about here till I find the tender spot. Have I found the tender spot yet?
Yeah, that's very good.
So yours is actually closer to this. And some people will say instead of the midpoint, say do each of them at a third of the distance.
Oh.
So if... There? Or... There?
Yeah, that's a little better.
All right, let's. And again, I just want to confirm that's the tender spot.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So we'll spray a little bit of ethyl chloride to make it cold. And then we'll give you a shot aiming upward to the spot, not wanting to hit the skull. Drawing back to make sure we're not in a blood vessel. And then going ahead and administering, I'm putting in 2 cc's of lidocaine with epinephrine with 0.2 cc's of sodium bicarbonate. You doing okay?
Yeah, I'm doing okay.
Okay, I wanna make sure you hadn't passed out.
No, I feel it though, but.
Yeah, I'm gonna fan it a little bit where I pull out and go back in, draw a little bit more in that direction. Are you still awake?
Yeah, I'm still here.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Is it hurting?
Yeah, a little bit, but that's okay. Back. I found out from my bursitis, that's like right on.
Okay. So this is the greater occipital nerve on the right. And then I'm going to push it in and massage it in. Still okay with this? Uh-huh. All right.
Thank you for checking. That's nice.
Well, I don't want to find out that you passed out by having my foot get warm all of a sudden. That's not the way you want to find out.
Have you ever had anyone pass out?
I haven't, but one of the instructors with Dr. Sahai was talking about that's how he found out that the patient passed out was his foot got warm.
Oh.
Yeah, you don't want to do that.
No.
Okay. And generally what they'll do is give the patient a bit of a break between the injections, because the closer you do them together, the more chance you're going to cause stimulation that can lead to them passing out. I'm going to very slowly go through this here and start to locate the lesser occipital nerve and start to clean the skin off with an alcohol wipe. But we're in no rush here. If you want me to slow down, I can.
No, I'm fine.
So we're going to find the prominence again. And
it kind of hurts all in that area.
Go two-thirds of the way over. Let me feel where the tragus is there so I know we're in the right spot. So most likely it's in this area.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Let me see.
Yeah, you can push on it.
That's right about there. It's
a real tender spot.
Let me see if it's even more. I'm just finding out, seeing if it is.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
No, it's right about there. Is that,
yes,
is that
it is.
The place it is?
Yes, it is.
Because that's where it's kind of feels like the...
Right there? Is that where you were?
Yeah. I think it was up a little bit. Come in. Yes, that is where I was, right there.
Yeah.
You're right.
Let me compare that again. I'm feeling the tragus, feeling the prominence on the occiput, and...
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that would be it.
Yeah,
let me give it a little spray.
So actually, what the heck, it can go all the way down here.
Oh yeah, you'll feel it all sorts of directions.
Yeah.
So this is getting a little cold in that area. To act as a local topical anesthetic, so we can give you an injection in that same spot where you said you felt it.
Uh-huh.
And I'm going to start to inject the medicine. It probably stings as it goes in. And there's a reason I'm directing from low to high on the patient's body, and that is to help to avoid accidental injection into the spinal canal.
No, we don't want to do that.
Which, if you're doing the opposite direction, there's a small risk, although with these small needles, it's less likely. And we make sure we're up on the skull, not down lower. So I'm fanning it out to get a larger area to spread out the anesthetic. And then I'm going to rub that one in. So that's the lesser occipital nerve.
Well,
good.
Neither one were that. Yeah.
Okay.
Wow.
So not too bad.
No.
Can you tell any change in the headache pain?
Not quite yet, but I can feel a little bit of my sinuses that, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
So there's tragus with that finger. And I know that people in the video can't, even somebody in person here can't see exactly what I'm touching because of the hair. But that's just the nature of it. So
is that where you're going to put the right there hurts?
No. Well, we can get what's called the dorsal occipital nerve. Most people don't have one, and it exists right here. And if you say,
oh, that's right there. Oh, you got it.
Well, you may have a dorsal occipital nerve. We will
is
go
that
ahead.
What that is?
We will give an injection there also.
Oh my gosh, that one hurts.
Okay, so what I'm hitting is an area that's actually just off to the side of midline, between the occipital prominence and the tragus of the ear,
mm-hmm.
on a line between them. And yeah, some people, that is their tender spot. So
wow.
Let me hit that on this one. And maybe we'll go back on the other one and hit it too.
You know, when you're hurt, you just hurt all over. You can't pinpoint where it is.
Okay, I'm gonna hit it one more time as far as my finger on it. Right about there.
Yes.
Yeah, some people, that'll be the spot to hit. All right, I'm gonna give you a shot there. Draw back, make sure there's no blood. Start to inject.
Ooh.
You said, ooh.
Ooh, I feel that one.
Fan it. Yeah?
Yeah, that's where it hurts.
That's where it hurts.
Yeah.
And we may have to do that also. On the other side.
So not everybody has that kind of nerve?
No. There's variations from person to person.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Got a little bleeding with that one, so I'm going to push it in.
Okay. Feels good when you push it in.
Yeah, we want to work that in.
Mm-hmm.
How's the headache?
Much better.
Better on one side or all over?
I would say just pretty much all over.
All over feels better.
Yeah, I have not had this kind of relief. I just didn't know what kind of med to take.
Now, when you say this kind of relief, you mean like this is the best it's felt in
two
or three weeks?
Yeah.
Well, that's certainly a good sign.
Almost making it go all the way. I can't believe it.
Okay.
Nice.
Good.
Mm-hmm.
So we're gonna journey over back to the right side because you seem to benefit from giving an injection where a dorsal occipital nerve would be located. So let's see if you have tenderness.
Oh yeah, there it is.
Oh boy.
Is that the same side? I mean, the same one on the same,
same
side.
Nerve on the right side. So we've hit two on the right side, which actually for most people will be complete. Not so for you.
Okay. I like being different.
Well, as long as we know it and we can identify it and make you feel better by taking into account how you're different.
Okay.
Then that's great. Still feeling okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right, we're going to.
I'm using up all your needles.
Yeah. So I find the prominence again. There it is.
There,
and then I go just lateral to it.
There you go, right there.
That
right
is it, there. Isn't it? Yep.
Oh, yeah, right there.
And the reason I know where to go is just because of how far it is, you know, just a centimeter, less than a centimeter over from. You can see some plastic there, that's okay. All right, gonna draw up and inject. You feeling it like you did that last one? So you're feeling it more than you did the other two.
Uh-huh.
All right, gonna move.
That's what I said, it's going re-inject. Down the back of my neck. It's just like, what?
Yeah, and how about going down the neck now? Is this causing any
much better.
Sensation there? Just less pain, huh?
Less pain, yeah. You're just.
Well, we may not have to do anything more than this. We may not have to do a greater and lesser on the left side.
Why not?
If this works. If this totally eliminates the pain, we don't have to. So let's rub that in and probably have you sit up for a little bit after getting four of those injections.
I feel like you should do the other two.
Still have headache?
No, it's pretty much gone.
And can you localize where you feel it? If it.
Well, I was getting it so much back here that I thought, well, my sinuses are in front, but I'm getting it back here. So that, you know, down my neck. And that's why it was weird.
Yeah.
Couldn't figure out what to do.
go ahead and raise your head up and sit up for a moment. How's that feel?
Fine, actually.
Yeah?
Wow.
Can you sort of point to a region or area that still hurts?
Well, it's like you blocked a lot. It's all gone. I have not felt this good in 3 weeks. I am serious. This is great. Okay. And it isn't bad. I didn't know what to expect.
Thank you so much for letting us do this.
Thank you very much.
And thank you for joining us. I do need to, if you'll allow me, to thank some people who helped make this possible, educational side of it. And that would be Boo Boo Kitty and Lindsay Antwine, our new patron Petra from Sweden. We thank you all for helping make this possible. You also can become a part of that by looking at the Auburn Medical Group Patreon. There'll be a link to that. And you can make sure you're subscribed to this channel if you like these type of medical videos and seeing patients who enjoy helping you learn about medicine like Rebecca here. Until next time, Dr. Mark Vaughn and Rebecca,
bye,
telling all of you to stay in good health.
Thank you.
Thanks, Rebecca.
Thank you. Oh my gosh, I can't believe, I know it's numb, but it's like, it's like...